In this video, we're going to look at a very specific binary operation and then prove that it is indeed an associative binary operation. So here's the setup. So capital X will be a set. So this is a set. And we're going to look at a set which is called the power set of capital X. This is equal to the set of all subsets of capital X. And what we're going to do is define a new binary operation, one that's different from union and intersection and set difference. It's called the symmetric difference. So the notation we'll use is a triangle. The triangle will denote the symmetric difference operation. So for two sets, for say capital A and capital B in the power set of capital X, in other words, they are subsets of capital X, we'll take A and we'll take the symmetric difference of A with B. And we'll define this to be all of the elements in A, but not in B, or, so union, all of the elements in B, but not in A. Let me write this down in English right below. This is the set of all elements that are in either A or B, but not in both. Okay, but not in both. That means if you write the symmetric difference of A with B in set builder notation, this is the set of all X such that X is in exactly one of AB. Okay, very, very useful to think of it this way. So X is in exactly one of AB. So if you have an element X that is not in your symmetric difference, okay, this is equivalent to saying that X is in either 0 or 2 of AB. So if it's in the symmetric difference, it's in exactly one of AB. So if it's not, it can't be in exactly one of AB. It's either in none of them or in both of them, right? So very, very useful. And so it turns out that the triangle, so used to using star for binary operations, that the symmetric difference is a binary operation. So it is indeed a binary operation on the power set of capital X. Okay, so it's a binary operation. It's also a commutative. So let me squeeze this in here. So it's commutative. It's a commutative binary operation on the power set. So in this video, we're going to focus on the proof of associativity. So let's carefully do that. So proposition. And the claim here is that the symmetric difference is associative. So we're going to prove that it is an associative binary operation on the power set of capital X. So we'll start by looking at A, and we'll take the symmetric difference of that with this. And we're just going to write it down in set builder notation. So we're not taking an element and showing the sets or subsets of each other. No. This is a much, much nicer proof. So what does it mean for an element to be in the symmetric difference of A with B symmetric difference C? Well, it means it's in exactly one of them. So X is in exactly one of A, and then B, symmetric difference C. That's what it means to be in that set. This is the set of all x such that, well, now let's rewrite what it means to be in exactly one of these two sets. That means that x is an A, and x is not in the other set. So x is not in B, symmetric difference C. Or it means x is not an A, and x is in the symmetric difference of B with C. So all we did was rewrite what it means to be in exactly one of those sets. Let's keep going. So this is the set of all x such that, well, let's take care of the first line here. Let's rewrite this. So this means x is an A. And, okay, now what does it mean to not be in the symmetric difference of B and C? It means it's in none or it's in both. Let's do the case where it's in none first. So that means x is not in B, and x is not in C. Or, again, x is in A, and this time we'll look at the case where it's in both. So it's in B, and it's in C. So everything we've written down so far is only for, here, I'll circle it, only for this, right? We rewrote this, and that means everything here. That means all of this stuff, okay? Now let's look at the second line. So x is not an A. And, well, what does it mean to be in the symmetric difference? It means it's in exactly one of BC. So let's look at the case first where it's in B, and it's not in C. Should have an or here, or. And then, again, x not an A. And the case where it's not in B, and it is in C. So it's in exactly one of BC. Let's close our set notation here. And here is the really cool part. So this is equal to the set of all x such that, well, in the first case, x is only in A, and it's not in the others. And the second case here, it's in all three. In the third case, it's only in B. And in the last case, it's only in C. So x is in exactly one or three of ABC, right? We can write it that way. So x is in exactly one or three of ABC. Now we'll look at asymmetric difference B, symmetric difference C. And we'll show it's equal to exactly the same thing. So this is the set of all x such that. Now what does it mean to be in the symmetric difference of this with this? It means x is in exactly one of asymmetric difference B, C. Let's keep going. Let's rewrite this. So let's write down what it means for x to be in exactly one of these sets. So that means that x is in the symmetric difference of A with B, and x is not in C, or x is not in the symmetric difference of A with B, and x is in C. That's what it means to be in exactly one of those sets. So I hope this makes sense so far. You really have to think carefully, but once you get it, it really is an amazing argument. All right, now again, we're going to focus on this first line here. So what does it mean to be in the symmetric difference of A and B? It means it's in exactly one of them. So x is in A, and x is not in B. That could be one case. And then we still have this x not in C. Or, and the other case would be x is not in A, and x is in B. And then here we still have this piece, x not in C. Or, now we'll go to the third line. So if x is not in the symmetric difference, that means it's in zero or it's in both. Let's look at the case where it's in zero of them. So x is not in A, and x is not in B. And then we still have this piece here, and x and c. Or, well, it's in both. So x is in a, and x is in b, and x is in c. Let's think about this carefully. Let's keep going. We're almost done. So this is the set of all x such that, well, let's see. Yep, it looks like in the first case, x is only in A. In the second case, x is only in B. In the third case, x is only in C. And the last case, x is in all of them. So x is in exactly one or three of ABC. Well, when we started the problem, we showed that if you take this, this is the set of all x such that x is in exactly 1 or 3 of ABC. Then we looked at it the other way. We did this, and we got the same thing. So x is in exactly 1 or 3 of ABC. So we showed that if you take A, symmetric difference, B, symmetric difference, C, you get A, symmetric difference, B, symmetric difference, C. Thus, the symmetric difference is associative on the power set of a set. So I hope this video has helped someone out there. I personally think this is a really, really nice argument. I hope this helps.